Hey everyone, it's Carissa here at Sprinkled with Glitter. Thanks for joining me today. Today I am sharing an adorable card featuring Lawn Fawn's brand new Magic Picture Changer die. I'm going to show you how to put this together. And I decided to keep the card overall pretty simple because I really wanted to focus on putting this picture changer together. I think you're going to be surprised at how easily this interactive card comes together, and I love dies like this that help you kind of add a little something extra to a simple card. So I am using the Lawn Fawn Year 5 Stamp and Die Set. This is a taco set, which I think is so adorable. It, of course, has the little faces that you can stamp onto the taco because that is signature Lawn Fawn. And I am starting out by stamping this taco and the sentiment that says, "Let's taco about," in some Copic-friendly ink onto some Nina Solar White 80-pound cardstock. Now, I have found that I prefer the 80-pound cardstock for this Magic Picture Changer because I feel like it just functions a little bit easier and the score lines are easier to kind of fold down. So that's what I'm using here today. Now, most of the time, I will use 110-pound because I prefer the heavier weight, but like I said, for this, I just feel like it's a little bit easier to assemble if you're using the 80-pound cardstock. Now, I've left my taco in its place, and I'm changing the sentiment. So this says your birthday. So the Magic Picture Changer is going to go from one taco to another taco. It's going to say, "Let's talk about your birthday." And on this taco that's on the inside, I'm going to put the little party hat and the smiley face. So I'm just kind of rubbing away a little bit of the ink at the upper left-hand side there so that I can add this little party hat. Now, you could definitely take the time to mask this, but quite honestly, I just was not in the mood. So I just wiped a little bit of the ink away, and I'm going to stamp my party hat and my little smiley face now, and that is my little party taco on the inside, because what really is a party without a taco? I am going to add some Copic coloring to this, and I'm just adding a little green to the lettuce. Now, the part on the inside that's kind of ruffly and sticking out, I guess that could kind of be, I don't know. I thought it was meat because I love me a good carne asada taco, but I guess that could be like tomatoes if you want it to be like more of a vegetarian taco. But you color this taco how you want to color it. If you want it to be chicken, if you want it to be cheese, you just go with it. I guess it could be the lettuce and maybe the little shreds that I have sticking out are the cheese. I don't know. But that's the wonderful thing about stamps is you can make them whatever you want to be, right? Now, for the shell, I used a couple of Copic colors. I will have them linked over at my blog. But these are two colors that don't really blend well together. So what I'm going to do is, as I'm blending this out, I'm like, it's not really blending. I'm going to grab that darker marker that I used for the shading, and I am going to touch the tip of that darker marker with my lighter marker and pick up a little bit of that darker ink to blend these two colors together. It's called tip-to-tip blending, and it does not damage your markers, but when you have two colors like this that kind of aren't blending really well together, then this is a great trick to try out. And you can just scribble off the tips of your Copic markers when you're done using this tip-to-tip method, and everything is good, I promise. Now, once I finish coloring these tacos, I'm going to start the die cutting with the Magic Picture Changer die set. And the larger die that you see here on the left-hand side, I'm going to use that to die cut the picture that is going to be first on the card so that you're going to see when this is in a neutral position. And I'm going to hold these in place with a little post-it tape while I run them through my die cut machine. Now, you could probably see there that that second piece, I had used a smaller piece of cardstock and it was not large enough for the inner slider piece of this Magic Picture Changer. So I had to restamp and color that, but no harm, no foul. I'll die cut that and use it on a different card. So now here's the deal on this. I wanted these tacos to be in pretty much the same position within the window once it changed from one to the other. So I played around with this a little bit to see how everything was lining up. And that bottom line there on the first piece of the Magic Picture Changer, it intersects with the corner of the bottom diagonal line. So I kind of grabbed that inner die. This is the inner slider portion, and that corner there of that line kind of intersects with that straight line. So I use that as a reference point to help line up this die onto this picture here so that I could keep the tacos and the sentiments kind of in the same place. I didn't want my taco to like jump up in the scene as it changed from one to the other. I just wanted it to magically appear with a party hat and a smiley face. So that's what I did there. And I die cut that out. And I think you're going to find that that works really well for lining these scenes up within the windows. Now, this Magic Picture Changer die does create the score lines for you. And you have to score these two little tabs that are along the outer pocket portion of this magic slider piece. So what I'm doing is I'm just getting the score line started with my fingers, and then I'm going to reinforce it with my bone folder and fold those tabs in. And before I add any adhesive or anything, I am going to slide my inner portion in, and I'm going to make sure that everything's lining up the way I want it. So I am going to take this first tab on the outer piece and feed it into the first slot or slit on the inner piece. And then I'm going to take the second tab into the second slot, the third tab into the third slot, and the fourth tab into the fourth slot. This makes a lot of sense as you're doing it, and it's really easy. I know it looks fumbly here, but it's really not at all. And then I'm going to just check the placement to make sure I have everything where I want it to be before I seal it up. So I'm just going to pull this up here, and there is my taco with the party hat. And I managed to get things to where they're not shifting around inside of that window. I was pretty happy with that. Now, I am out of 1/8 inch score tape, and that's what you really want to use here because it makes this a lot easier. But I'm out of it, so I'm just using a little glue tube. And I am adding it on to the inner part of those tabs and folding them down to where they're on the inside of this pocket piece. And because this glue takes a second to kind of set up and adhere, I had to kind of go over that with my bone folder several times to make sure those were adhered down really well. But I would definitely recommend 1/8 inch score tape. I have more on order, but I'm waiting for it. So now I'm going to assemble this for good, and I'm going to take the tab and add it through the opening at the top. And then I'm going to take these little tabs and slide them into the coordinating slits once again. And this is going to be the final time I'm going to do it. I just thought it would be beneficial for you to kind of see this twice in a couple of different angles so that you really got the hang of it. And then I'm going to add some more glue tube onto that top part of those tabs. I'm making sure that it's not overlapping. And then I'm going to make sure that inner portion, that slider portion, is within those tracks that I'm creating with those tabs. And then I'm going to close this up. Once again, score tape, so much better because you're not worrying about the glue kind of seeping into the areas where you have the slider portion going and kind of impeding the movement of this. So if you have the score tape, I definitely recommend using that. But I was able to make this work with the glue tube. Now, I wanted to add some confetti to the little party taco, but I forgot to do that before I die cut it. So I just took a colored pencil and drew some confetti on the inside of that scene. And now I'm going to cut a couple of pieces. The frame that's on that blue cardstock on the bottom, that is a part of the Magic Picture Changer die set. The cover portion that I'm die cutting from this green cardstock on the top, that is from the Magic Picture Changer add-on die set, and it covers this entire kind of Magic Picture Changer area. I decided that I didn't like the blue frame, so I went ahead and re-die cut that from some pink cardstock, and I'm going to add it to that Magic Picture Changer add-on piece there with a little bit of foam adhesive. Now, there is one little trick you want to keep in mind when you're adhering either the frame or this picture changer add-on cover portion. You want to only add your adhesive from the inner corner to the outer corner of these frames, and that's going to keep you from adding adhesive where it's going to impede the movement of your slider there. So that is the same also for that little frame that I've added onto the front. If you want to add that directly onto the picture changer, you can do that, but just make sure you're just adding it from that corner to the outer corner to keep everything moving freely. Now, this little pull tab is kind of cool because it acts as a stopper and keeps that inner portion from sliding out the bottom. This particular pull tab comes from the Magic Picture Changer add-on. There is also one included with the Magic Picture Changer die set, and it has a little arrow on it. So now I have my Magic Picture Changer all put together. I'm just going to finish decorating this a little bit. I'm going to put a embossed happy birthday sentiment onto this blue cardstock here. I have a little bit of blue in the background. I'm not sure if you can see it around the tacos. I just took a Copic marker and just kind of colored a light blue background. And this new wavy banner die set is like super favorite of mine from Lawn Fawn. I love me a good wavy banner, and the wavy sentiments coordinate perfectly. And there's so many. There's one for like every occasion you could think of. So I thought I would just add that up in the corner there. And then I'm going to take this entire piece and I'm going to add it on to a card base using foam adhesive. Now, I do recommend using foam adhesive to add this picture changer onto your card front because it makes that tab a little easier to get a hold of. Now, if things are not kind of gliding the way that you want them to, you can take your powder tool and just kind of go over this kind of sliding area with it. And that will kind of help everything kind of lubricate up a little bit and slide across itself a little easier, I guess. I mean, you know what I'm saying, right? It just kind of makes everything kind of glide. And you can see there is my Magic Picture Changer. It was so easy to put together, and I'm always pleasantly surprised when you can find these interactive dies like this that are relatively easy to assemble and they're not super complicated. Now here I've used this to change from a picture to a picture, but you could change from a picture to a sentiment or from a sentiment to a picture. And you can use this with stamp sets that you already have, and I think it's so much fun. Lawn Fawn has also designed a couple before and after stamp sets that work perfectly with this Magic Picture Changer as well. And I'll be sharing a card idea over on the Ellen Hudson blog featuring one of those this weekend, so be sure to check that out. As always, I will have links to the featured supplies used in this project in the description at YouTube. So if you're looking for something in particular, be sure to check there. But you can also head on over to my blog at sprinkledwithglitter.com. I'll have that linked below. Over there, you'll find more still shots, more information, and a complete list of supplies. Thanks for stopping by and hanging out with me today. I hope you enjoyed this project. If you did, be sure to give this video a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel and turn on the notifications so you won't miss any of my card making video tutorials. As always, I'm so glad you're here. Thanks for hanging out with me today. Thanks for watching, and until next time, I hope you have a fabulous day.